it's very difficult to find something that one of these machines can't make. And things that I cannot make out of metal. And you can't build it as fast as you want to out of metal. If it's not right, then you lose the whole part. With these, rapid prototyping is everything. It's what they're really, really good at.
A little bit off the sharp corners will make it look really nice.
Oh, that's,
it'll kind of stretch
true.
It out. Yes, it's not this. But see, this is where I was telling them I had to use this quarter 20 because this is not small. Rapid prototyping, I can't get over that. When people want to see something now in a week instead of 2 months, 3 months, we can build it in 2 weeks and they can try it out. And if it works, then we'll make it a viable part and we'll use it. We've done that here. We have made parts that I can't make out of metal and the students have used them. And they'll use them over and over.
It's filament based. We printed all these gears and they all work. We have a motor hooked up to it. Electric clutches on this side. When you'd engage a clutch, now you'd get rotation over here on this side. And it's, again, quite, I can't make that in metal. In, you know, any length of time that's acceptable. And they're very solid, very strong. And this is just another show and tell device for a learning tool for the students. The biggest projects, and one of them was Michael Alea, they build CubeSats, little small tissue box size satellites that they'll send up into space on a weather balloon. It'll gather data and it'll come back down. And they have printed several of these CubeSats on Handsome Beast. And they're strong enough to stand on. You can physically step up on them. But they are so complex and yet so simple, it would take me days to make one in metal, where they'll print one in half a day over here. And it's so accurate. It is so incredibly accurate is what I can't get over.